food and drink are strictly prohibited here at the Queen's Gardens in Wonderland. And the Queen will have your head if you are caught recording or using flash photography. Furthermore, we will all go absolutely mad if you don't put away your cell phones. Silence them! Put them away now! Freddie Mercury is wishing us a good evening and a jolly good show from the great Wonderland in the sky. And on behalf of Miss Burlingame and Miss Emery, please enjoy tonight's presentation of Alice's Adventures in Wonderland, featuring the music of Queen.
Beginning to get very tired of sitting by her sister on the bank and of having nothing to do. Once or twice, she had peeped into the book her sister was reading, but it had no pictures or conversations in it.
And what is the use of a book without pictures or conversation?
So she was considering in her own mind whether the pleasure of making a daisy chain would be worth the trouble of getting up and picking the daisies.
Oh, the slightest smile, or destroy me with a very acceptable whisper. Take me, remember I'll be dreaming of my baby at the dreamer's ball.
She fell very slowly, for she had plenty of time as she went down to look about her and wonder what was going to happen next.
Yeah.
yesterday things went on just as usual. I wonder if I've been changed in the night. Let me think. Was I the same when I got up this morning? I almost think I can remember feeling a little different. But if I'm not the same, who in the world am I?
Alice remembered trying to box her own ears once for having cheated herself in a game of croquet she was playing against herself. For this curious child was very fond of pretending to be two people. There were doors all around the hall, but they were all locked, and when Alice had been all the way down one side and up the other, trying every door, she walked soundly down the middle, wondering how she was ever to get out again.
It's a kind of magic. It's a kind of magic. A kind of magic. One dream, one soul, one prize, one gold, one golden glance of what should be. It's a kind of magic. One chance, all life, actions away. No more of man can end this day. It's a kind of magic. A bell that rings inside your mind. It's your thing. Because of time, it's a kind of magic. The way it is, it's
to go on crying in this way. Stop right this instant.
But she went on all the same, shedding gallons of tears, until there was a large pool all around her. In another moment, splash, she was up to her chin in salt water.
I demand your best.
getting quite crowded with the little birds and animals that had fallen into it. There were a duck and a dodo, a lory and an eaglet, and several other curious creatures. Alice led the way, and the whole party swam to the shore. They were indeed a queer-looking party that assembled on the bank. The birds with draggled feathers, the animals with their fur clinging close to them, and all dripping wet, cross and uncomfortable. The first question was, of course, how to get dry again. The mouse, who seemed to be a person of authority among them, called out,
"The best thing to get us dry would be a caucus race."
"What is a caucus race?"
"Why, the best way to explain it is to do it."
First, the mouse marked out a race course in a sort of circle.
"The exact shape doesn't matter."
And then all the party were placed along the course, here and there. There was no 1, 2, 3 in a way, but they began racing when they liked and left off when they liked, so that it was not easy to know when the race was over.
Bicycle! Bicycle! Bicycle!
I want to ride my
Magpie began wrapping itself up very carefully, remarking,
"I really must be getting home. The night air doesn't suit my throat."
And a canary called out in a trembling voice to its children, "Come away, my dears. It's high time you were all in bed." On various pretexts, they all moved off. Alice wandered on, talking to herself as she went, till she came upon two little men. They were standing under a tree, each with an arm around the other's neck. And Alice knew which was which in a moment, because one of them had dumb embroidered on his collar, and the other D.
I suppose they've each got Tweedle written at the back of the collar.
They stood so still that she quite forgot they were alive, and when she was just looking around to see if the word Tweedle was written at the back of each collar, when... footsteps in the distance. It was the White Rabbit muttering to itself.
The Duchess! The Duchess! Oh, my dear paws on my fur and whiskers! She'll get me executed as sure as ferrets are ferrets! Where can I have dropped them, I wonder?
Very soon, the rabbit noticed Alice as she went hunting about and called out to her in an angry tone.
Why, Marianne! What are you doing out here? Run home this moment and fetch me a pair of gloves and a fan. Quick now!
Thank you. so slashed and torn.
Surprised that the pebbles were all turning into little cakes as they lay on the floor. So she swallowed one of the cakes and was delighted to find that she began shrinking directly. She ran off as hard as she could and soon found herself safe in a thick wood.
How puzzling all these changes are. I'm never sure where I'm going to be from one moment to another.
There was a large mushroom growing near her, about the same height as herself, and sitting on the top was a large blue caterpillar.
Who are you?
I hardly know, sir, just a present. At least, I know who I was when I got up this morning, but I think I must have been changed several times since then.
What do you mean by that? Explain yourself.
I can't explain myself, I'm afraid, sir, because I'm not myself, you see?
Thank you. through sorrow, all through our splendor. Don't take offense at my innuendo.
Set to work very carefully, nibbling first at one and then the other, till she had succeeded in bringing herself to her usual height. She then came upon an open place with a little house in it.
Rock and world go round.
going to turn into a pig, my dear, then I'll have nothing more to do with you. Mind now. If it had grown up, it would have made for a dreadfully ugly child. But it makes a rather handsome pig, I think.
Alice began thinking over other children she knew who might do very well as pigs, and was just saying to herself,
if one only knew the right way to change them.
When she was a little startled by seeing the Cheshire Cat sitting on the bough of a tree a few yards off.
I'm the Invisible Man. I'm the Invisible Man.
Incredible how you can.
Lives a hatter, and in that direction lives a march hare. Visit either you like, they're both mad.
But I don't want to go among mad people.
We're all, you can't help that. We're all mad here. I'm mad, you're mad.
How do you know I'm mad?
You must be, or you wouldn't have come here.
I wish you wouldn't keep appearing and vanishing like that. You make one quite giddy.
This time it vanished quite slowly. Beginning with the head and ending with the... the tail, and ending with the grin, which remained some time after the rest of it had gone.
Well, I've often seen a cat without a grin, but a grin without a cat? It's the most curious thing I've ever seen in my life.
She had not gone much farther before she came in sight of a house of the March Hare. She thought it must be the right house, because the chimneys were shaped like ears and the roof was thatched with fur. There was a table set out under a tree in front of the house, and the March Hare and the Hatter were having tea at it. A dormouse was sitting between them, fast asleep, and the other two were using it as a cushion, resting their elbows on it and talking over its head.
Very uncomfortable for the dormouse, only as it's asleep, I suppose it doesn't mind.
I
too far away. Our story of Wonderland has not reached its end. Soon you will meet the Queen of Hearts and all her court, and a couple of best friends.
Far better if I could get to the top of that hill. Here's a path that leads straight to it, at least. No, it doesn't do that, but I suppose it will at last. But how curiously it twists.
Abandoned.
about looking glass house. I've held up one of our books to the glass, and then they hold up one in the other room. It's very like our passage, as far as you can see, only you know it may be quite different on beyond. Oh, how nice it would be if we could only get through into Looking Glass House.
The glass was beginning to melt away, just like a bright, silvery mist. Entrance of the garden. The roses growing on it were white, but there were three gardeners at it, busily painting them red. Alice thought this was a very curious thing, and she went nearer to watch them.
Would you tell me, why are you painting those roses?
Why, the fact is, you see, miss, they say it ought to have been a red rose tree, and we put a white one in by mistake, and if the queen was to find out, we should all have our heads cut off, you know.
You bring disgrace, kicking your can all over. Can you play croquet?
The soldiers were silent and looked at Alice as the question was evidently meant for her.
Yes.
Come on, then.
Alice joined the procession, wondering very much what would happen next. Affectionately into Alice's, and they walked off together.
She keeps them always shunned on in a pretty cabinet. Nothing in case, she says, just like Marie Antoinette. Building a remedy for whose job and identity is a little invitation you get to keep.
Blow your mind.
Queen sent the Duchess away and took Alice to meet the Mock Turtle and his best friend, the Griffin.
Come, let's hear some of your adventures.
I can tell you of my adventures starting from this morning, but it's no use going back to yesterday because I was a different person then.
Deeply, recovered his voice, and then he went on again.
You may not have lived that much under the sea, and perhaps you were never even introduced to a lobster, so you can have no idea what a delightful thing a lobster quadrille is.
No, indeed. What sort of a dance is it?
Why, first you form into a line along the seashore.
Two lines, then one you clear all the jellyfish out of the way.
That generally takes some time.
Of course, advance twice, set to partners.
Change lobsters and retire in the same order.
Then you throw the lobsters out as far as you can.
Swim after them.
Then somersault in a sea.
Change lobsters again.
Back to land again, and that's all the first figure.
It must be a very pretty dance.
Would you like to see a little of it?
Very much indeed.
Come, let's try the first figure.
Oh,
shouts beginning was heard in the distance. The griffin took Alice by the hand, and they hurried off. The king and queen of hearts were seated on their throne when they arrived, with a great crowd assembled about them. All sorts of little birds and beasts, as well as the whole pack of cards. The knave was standing before them in chains, with a soldier on each side to guard him. And near the king was the white rabbit with a trumpet in one hand and a scroll of parchment in the other. In the very middle of the court was a table with a large dish of tarts upon it. The white rabbit blew three blasts on the trumpet and then unrolled the parchment scroll and read as follows.
The queen of hearts, she made some tarts all in a summer day. The knave of hearts, he stole those tarts and took them quite away.
Is this the real life? Is this just fantasy? Caught in a landslide, no escape from reality. Open your eyes, look up to the skies and see. I'm just a poor boy, because I'm easy come, easy go.
Let's go.
Pleasanter at home when one isn't always growing larger and smaller and being ordered about by mice and rabbits. I almost wish I hadn't gone down that rabbit hole, and yet it's rather curious, you know, that sort of life. I do wonder what can have happened to me. When I used to read fairy tales, I fancied that kind of thing never happened, and now there I was in the middle of one. There ought to be a book written about me, that there ought. When I grow up, I'll write one.
Oh, Alice, when you grow up, you will keep this simple and loving heart of your childhood. And you will gather about you other little children and make their eyes bright and eager with many a strange tale, perhaps even with this dream of Wonderland. And you will feel all their simple sorrows and joys, remembering your own child life and the happy summer days.
I've paid my dues time after time.